God bless you. Bishop Patrick L. Wooden Sr. here, prelate of North Carolina 3rd Jurisdiction. And I'm here today to talk to you about a tremendous event that's going to take place on April the 18th through the 20th. It will be our first, under yours truly's leadership, Ministers and Workers Conference, the 18th through the 20th. As a matter of fact, it's the first Workers Conference that NC3rd will have had of its kind. And we have a tremendous, tremendous service that is planned on behalf of our supervisor, Mother Beverly Dejeuner. What a supervisor she is. I'm so excited about the opportunity to work with her. On her behalf, we are inviting you, the members of NC3rd, and all who will hear this, to attend this Ministers and Workers Conference Revival service that will strengthen pastors, strengthen the local church, strengthen the saints, and you will leave this Ministers and Workers Conference encouraged to go back and to minister and do the work of the Lord where God has planted you. Now, we have some wonderful things in store. One of the things is on Wednesday night, the 18th, my chief of staff, Superintendent Tommy Eugene Quick from Spartanburg, South Carolina, the superintendent of the South Carolina district, will be ministering the word of God here on that Wednesday night. And you don't want to miss this man of God. He's highly anointed. God has given him a word, and we're going to be blessed on that evening. On Thursday night, the 19th, we have an awesome woman of God coming to share with us. She is Supervisor Janice Craig, North Texas Central Ecclesiastical Jurisdiction. This woman of God is a warrior for Christ. She engages the culture. She has the courage of her conviction. Every time I have heard her, I have been moved, and I said, God, I gotta get this lady. And she has agreed to share with us on the 19th as we honor our supervisor, Mother Beverly Dejeuner. I want you to come and be a part of the service. You will leave on fire, ready to minister, ready to witness, ready to live the life, because God has put a word in this woman's mouth, and God is going to use her. On the 20th, yours truly, I will be giving the official message on the 20th, and I'll say to you what God has given me to say to you at that time. During the day, we're going to have some awesome seminars. We're going to be talking about some subjects that will bless pastors, that will bless members, that will bless churches. We want to talk about pastoral support. Pastors need to be supported. Pastors need prayer. Pastors need to have all hands on deck in their local churches. We're going to talk about engaging the culture. We're going to be talking about the necessity of effective youth ministry. You know that Satan is targeting our young people. Well, Satan's not the only one targeting our young people. We are targeting our young people, and we're going to target them with the Word of God and instructions from the God of the Bible. There are so many things. Listen to this. We're going to have a seminar and do discussion and teachings on the necessity of building a strong men's ministry in our church. In the African American community in particular, our men, oh, we got to reach out for our men, because you know, you can see what Satan is doing. You can see how he's targeting our brothers and sisters, but he's really targeting our men. And we want our brothers to know that it's cool, it's right, it's all right to be a man of God, to be responsible, to make good decisions, to achieve, to be about something. Well, we're going to talk about these things. Just so many things that we have planned that will help us, as I mentioned, building our pastor's aid, and also cause-driven members. We want people to come and be a part of our church. We want everyone to come, but we want people to come who are willing to work for the Lord. My friends, the Lord doesn't just save us so that we can get and gain, but he saves us to become a part of the kingdom, to promote the God of the Bible's kingdom agenda. Jesus said, pray this prayer, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. And we want to turn out kingdom people who will fight the good fight of faith, engage the culture, tell people what the truth is, who will not cower. And I guarantee you this, by the time these three nights have concluded, yes, only three nights, you will be inspired to serve at your local church, to be a voice in your community, to stand for the Lord Jesus, to be, in fact, a presser. So on behalf of the greatest supervisor, I think, in the world, I'm so honored to have the opportunity to work with Supervisor Beverly Dejeuner. I'm so honored to have the opportunity to work with the members of North Carolina 3rd Jurisdiction. I pray that as you watch this on the NC 3rd Facebook page or on our website, or wherever you may see this, whether it's Upper Room, wherever you may see this, I pray that you will make preparations. I pray that you will come and be blessed of the Lord and highly favored. You're going to be blessed during the meeting, but you're really going to be blessed by the effects and the deposit and the impartation that will be made in your life when the meeting is over and you return to your local church and you return to your place of abode and you go home and begin to work out and walk out and live out the things that you're going to learn. Day and night, day sessions, seminars during the day, church services at night, April the 18th through the 20th, North Carolina 3rd Jurisdiction, our ministers and workers meeting, and we're putting the ministers and the workers to work. God bless you.